Hi, everyone. Ron Crider reporting for duty today. It is Sunday. I got these numbers in about 3 o'clock this afternoon. Well, they are coming down a little bit. That's probably the good thing. Yesterday, we had 207 new deaths in the past 24 hours. Today, we have 132. So we're down by 75, so that's a good thing. And as far as the new positives are concerned for the entire state of Florida, 11,093. Yesterday, we had 12,119. We're down by 1,026. I mean, these are still very large numbers. Fact is, they are seem to be going in the right direction. But then again, we have to understand that this is a weekend. This is Sunday. Numbers are always a little bit lower on the weekends than they are during the week, generally. Alrighty, number of people vaccinated in the entire state of Florida so far, 1,007,716. In the past 24 hours, 70,086. A lot of people vaccinated. 70,000 people got vaccinated in the past 24 hours. Pretty amazing. So we're making some progress. Got a long way to go. Remember, we got 22 million people living here in the state of Florida. Alrighty, Miami-Dade, 34 new deaths to report, 2,404 new positives in the past 24 hours down there. 115,982 people have been vaccinated thus far in Miami. 6,382 were vaccinated in the past 24 hours. In Broward County, that's Fort Lauderdale, 12 new deaths in the past 24 hours, 1,172 new positives. 90,000 people have been vaccinated, 90,666 in the Fort Lauderdale-Broward County area, and in the past 24 hours, they vaccinated 5,372. Then up in Palm Beach County, 3 new deaths to report, 799 new positives, 82,668 are the number of vaccinations that have been given out in Palm Beach County thus far. Yesterday, they did 7,340. And then in Orange County, that's Orlando, 18 new deaths to report up there in Orlando, 741 new positives, and they've vaccinated so far 60,479. And in the past 24 hours, they vaccinated 4,307. Then we'll go over to Brevard County. That's Melbourne. 4 new deaths to report in the past 24 hours. 250 new positives. And total number of vaccinations in Brevard County thus far, 24,219. And in the past 24 hours, they vaccinated 1,569 people. Alrighty, here we are in St. Lucie County. 5 new deaths to report. St. Lucie County is Fort Pierce. 5 new deaths to report, 96 new positives. They've vaccinated 13,218 people in St. Lucie County. I believe they have a couple hundred thousand people living in that county for sure, so that's not much of a dent. 2,175 people vaccinated in the past 24 hours. Then in Martin County, there were no new deaths. Good job there. No new deaths in Martin County. 42 new positives in the past 24 hours. 7,948 total vaccinations given out in Martin County so far. 904 in the past 24 hours. Then we're in Indian River County. That's where we are today. 5 new deaths to report in the past 24 hours. 86 new positives. Here we have vaccinated so far 7,255, and in the past 24 hours, 698. 7,255, and we have 155,000 people in our county. Got a long way to go, don't we? All righty, let's move down here a little bit now and take a look at the zip codes for Indian River County. Zip code 32948, 4 new positives in the past 24 hours. Zip code 32958, 18 new positives. Zip code 32960, Vero Beach proper, 10 new positives in the past 24 hours. Zip code 32962, 12 new positives in the past 24 hours. Zip code 32963 here on the Barrier Island, 4 new positives in the past 24 hours. Zip code 32966, 10 new positives. Zip code 32967, 19 new positives in the past 24 hours. And zip code 32968, 8 new positives in the past 24 hours. All of these that I just gave you were in the past 24 hours. Alrighty, folks, let's move down here and take a look at this other chart that I have for you here. I was giving you the 7-day moving averages, but the numbers are so huge. If you can look up here, the number is 160.14. You remember when we were back in the 70s and the 60s, and now we're 160.14? That means 160, approximately 160 people passed away each day for the past 7 days. Each day for the past 7 days is a result of COVID-19. All righty, these numbers I have down here, they are a result of Bloomberg, mostly Bloomberg numbers. Actually, this should say Sunday up here instead of Saturday. Apologize for that. All right, let's talk about this. Total number of distributed vials of vaccine in the United States that were distributed to all the states so far, 31,161,075, 31 million. Administered so far, 13,670,710. And then new vaccinations in the past 24 hours, 708,160. Almost a million people were got vaccinated in one day. And the number of deaths in the United States in the past 24 hours, total United States, 948. That's because it's a dark number, that's reported as of today. Now, in Texas, they have vaccinated 40,513 in the past 24 hours. And 48 hours ago, there were 415 people that had passed away in Texas. In California, 115,744 people were vaccinated in the past 24 hours. 40 people passed away in the past 48 hours. I don't have up-to-date numbers for 24 hours quite yet. That's why you're seeing yesterday's numbers there. As I said, Florida, 70,086 number of people who have been vaccinated thus far here in the state of Florida. And this is in the past 24 hours. Number of people in the past 24 hours who have been vaccinated, 70,086. 132 new deaths in the past 24 hours here. Rhode Island, I don't have anything to report there except 9 new deaths. I don't have any vaccinations to report for Rhode Island, but I do have 9 deaths 48 hours ago. Colorado, 20 deaths 48 hours ago. They did vaccinate 15,481 in the past 24 hours. Wisconsin, I don't have any numbers for new vaccinations in Wisconsin, although in the past 24 hours, they did have 128 new deaths. In Minnesota, 8,306 new vaccinations in the past 24 hours, 40 new deaths in the past 24 hours. Those are recent numbers. And then we're going to go up to New Jersey. New Jersey had 19,117 new vaccinations in the past 24 hours and 24 new deaths in Jersey. Then we'll go to New York. We have New York and New York City. Now, I am going to give you New York right now, 33,454. I don't have a number for the city. I'll have that starting tomorrow because I have to separate the city from the state. And they had 159 for the entire state of new deaths in the state of New York. Like I say, these numbers over here were going to be separated out. So this New York State, 1,884 number of vaccinations that were distributed up there. There's also another 800,000 that were distributed just to New York City. All righty, folks, let's go up here and take a look at what we refer to as the absolute worst numbers. We don't like these numbers, but everybody likes to see them, so here we go. Total number of cases in the United States, 23,844,928. Those are the number of cases since we started back in March. Number of positive cases here in the United States. Number of deaths, I keep saying we're closing in on 400,000. So far in the United States, 396,682 deaths in the United States. The biggest number of all on the chart is the 94,786,639. 94 million people plus 786 were diagnosed with COVID-19 in the entire world. And then for the number of deaths, we passed 2 million the other day, 2,026,792, the number of deaths in the entire world since COVID started. Alrighty, folks, those are our numbers for Sunday. For today, it is January the 17th. Finishing up these numbers now at 3:25. Hopefully by 4:30, you should have them posted and you'll be able to see where we are. This might be a good time to give me a like. Hey, I might get a like even because our numbers came down, and I hope you liked the video. I keep trying to do a good job for you here. I've been doing this. I'm almost hitting 300 days. I'm not exactly sure. I stopped keeping track of the days. It was a little bit depressing because when I originally started doing this, I was thinking, oh, I'll do it for a month or two because this will probably be going away pretty quickly. Who would believe that We're approaching 360 days. We're approaching a year here in doing this, and I've been doing it just about every day. I missed a couple of days, not because I was playing hooky. No. And I didn't do that. I didn't have anything for Christmas Day. I didn't have anything for Thanksgiving Day. Didn't have anything for New Year's Day. They didn't give me any numbers to report. Now, I maybe could have done a report, but gave me a little breather as well. So at least I missed 3 days there. I think I missed a couple of other days. I believe 4th of July or Labor Day, one of those days, there were no numbers as well. So anyway, I've been trying to do a good job for you. I have a lot of very loyal watchers, pretty much in the 70s right now for the number of people who watch every day. We used to be well over 100. And I know you're kind of getting a little sick of these numbers. And besides, I tell you every day, don't watch it every day. It's like weighing yourself every day. You know, you just don't feel like you're getting anywhere. And unfortunately, you come back and look at it 3 or 4 days later, and it seems like we're getting worse instead of better. Now, this will stop. This will start slowing down, and you are the only one that can make this slow down. You just have to start social distancing, wear those masks, stop going out to bars and hanging out with people. Ears to elbows. There is another expression I will not use on here, but it's being so close to people that your ears and your elbows are getting ready to pretty much meet each other. And I have to tell you, yeah, there are a lot of bars with a lot of people doing that these days. And not just bars. There are other places where people are congregating and getting quite close together. And it's just a really bad thing. And I also want to remind you, I said this yesterday, I'm going to keep saying it now, this is not like the flu. COVID-19, he's not like the flu at all. When you get it, you might have underlying issues like respiratory problems, heart problems, lung problems, all sorts of terrible things that may be with you for quite some time. We don't know how long because he hasn't been around here quite a year, but a lot of people who got it early on had these issues, and other people are also beginning to get those underlying medical conditions as well. So don't just think, oh, big deal, I'll get it and it'll go away. No, I don't really care about it. And don't think about the fact that, well, there's no point in getting a shot. Why should I get a shot? Good heavens, I don't need to get a shot. It's my recommendation that you should get a shot. Don't debate me on that because everybody's entitled to their opinion. Hey, the Pope got his second shot, if I'm not mistaken. And in fact, both popes, the one who is sort of retired now, both of the popes have gotten their COVID-19 shots. So you hear these stories about it's made with a vaccine, a product of aborted children. That is absolutely, totally not true. The research was done with that when they were researching these things, but there is none of that in these products right now. So don't give that a second thought and don't use that as an excuse, okay? All right, sorry about the preaching. It is Sunday. I guess I get to preach on Sunday. Sunday's just about over, though. The day is about to be dwindled down and the sun's going to start going down and coming up a little bit earlier every day. So I look forward to seeing you back here on Monday. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to push the like button. Appreciate that very much. Ron Crider signing off for Sunday. Look forward to seeing you back here on Monday.